So if you're happy, are you happy starting at this end, just to answer those questions briefly from your own perspective, that would be really nice.
Thank you very much. I'm Jeff Dale. I've been ward member since 2003 for Oakham North East. I've worked in Oakham all my life. That's 55 years I went to Oakham School. So I know Oakham pretty well. My biggest concern is that Oakham's stagnating. We need to get something done to make it more vibrant for people to come. We've got one of the biggest assets out there, Oakham Water. We must encourage more people to come from there into the town. We've got some fabulous eating places and shopping places. What we don't sell ourselves enough. With the high street, I'll wait to hear what comes out of the meetings to see whether we go one way or two way. But to my mind, we've got to work together to get this done and make Oakham somewhere that we're proud of. I would like to be able to say in 10 years' time, I was part of that, and I'm pleased with what we've done. You look down Oakham High Street, what have we done in the last 20, 30 years? We haven't done anything, really. I mean, we repair a few pavements, we do a bit of, alter the streetlights and things like that, but we haven't actually took the bull by the horns. We've got on with doing something that will attract people into Oakham. And we've got the facilities there, but we're not selling ourselves. So I truly believe that if we can get together, we can look back in, as I say, in 10 years' time and say, hey, look, we've done that and we've made it really nice. So that's why I want to be on this panel. Thank you.
Thank you.
So, like Julian, I've been in business for 30 odd years in Oakham, and I was born in the area, and I've got a great passion for seeing Oakham succeed. I think we've got some great assets, as Jeff has already discussed, which we need to maximise on to try and generate more footfall into the town. We certainly need to turn back the even decade of lack of maintenance and any improvements in the town to make it more attractive. There are issues as to the balance of the shops, which aren't directly concerning the council, because they have no control, but we ought to be able to encourage the landlords to be a bit more discerning about who they let to, so we get a better balance. We've got too many, dare I say, charity shops. We need a better balance of businesses to try and make the town a destination again. For many years we were very lucky with Furley's. Furley's really was a destination for many people. And having lost that was perhaps one of the most attractive management, making it more pedestrian friendly, and really a place that would be a joy to come to. And we've got parts of it, we've got around the Buttercross and the marketplace and that, and the regeneration that was proposed was not in keeping with the market town image. We need to keep that. That's one of the fundamental things we've got.
Okay, if we can kind of move on then, Richard. Thank you, Tim. And if you could a little bit reflect on, we've all said we want to have a better town in future, kind of reflect a little bit on what is the role of this group in helping us get there?
Thank you. I'm going to start with your first point about concerns. And I suppose one of my concerns of the Task and Finish Group, or for the Task and Finish Group, is ensuring that we are truly representative. And it is a difficult one, because I've just quickly looked around this room, and I don't wish to be horrible to anybody, but I'm probably one of the youngest people sat in here, and I don't consider myself to be young anymore. So I think we've got to be a little bit careful that actually we don't end up with something that, and I know what you're saying, Tim, you want to keep the market town as it is and everything else, but my concern is that actually we also need it to be progressive as well, and if we're not careful, we end up being stuck in the past, and then actually that might not help businesses or anything else. So we do need to strike that balance, and I think representation is really important. And I, like other councillors, I'm sure, have been had numerous conversations with people about having more residents input onto the panel and everything else. And I think my concern is that we don't want a panel that's huge, but we've got to make sure that that panel actually gets to hear from everybody and hear from a cross-section representation. And that, for me, is more important than who sat on it, if I'm totally honest. And therefore, the communication that goes out from that is my two concerns, that everybody understands that's what's happening. Sorry, I'm going to go over in 90, but as far as representation is concerned, I suppose from my point of view, I think as ward members, we are representatives of the residents, and we should do our job to make sure that we represent them. I'm also a son of a shopkeeper and have been here all my life, so I've lived on Oakham High Street for at least 25 years of my life, so I do know it very well. What I want this group to achieve is some very clear recommendations that go to council that actually will form an improvement plan or drive an improvement plan for the town itself. We can't have a woolly aspiration. We want some clear recommendations that actually the council can vote yes or no on.
Thank you. Thank you. I thought for a moment you were going to claim to be a 25-year-old.
I'd love to, but it would be a lot.
Thank you.
Ben Callaghan, ward member, Oakham South East. I echo the previous comments. It's pointless trying to restate what's already been said very, very well. One of my concerns is that it's getting consensus. And I think we've seen through a lot of communication that there are many, many different viewpoints, and everyone would like to have their say. They want to have their idea as the final idea. Clearly that's not going to work. It has to be something that suits as much as possible everybody, bearing in mind that you can't suit all the people all the time, or please all the people all the time. So that's going to be a challenge. I'd be interested to see how we address that. From a contribution point of view, I will contribute, and it sounds a bit cliche, but energy, but experience as both a long-standing Rutland resident, ever since I was 10, and I'll leave you to work out how long that is, but hopefully you estimate it to be less than it really. But also somebody that's travelled extensively and lived abroad, so I've lived in many sort of foreign cities, and I've seen what they've been able to do with their places. To me, one of the towns and cities that stand out are the ones that preserve their green areas. And I think we've done a terrible job in this town preserving our green areas. I think every time we've got open space, we go and build on it, and I think that's a travesty, I really do. So if that was something that could be built into any discussions, I'd be delighted. And I think from, in terms of outcomes, a successful conclusion would be one that is positioned open as an attractive town, both for residents, but more importantly as well, for in terms of our future business enterprises, for visitors. We've got to be able to attract people here and have them want to stay and spend money. And so they're the kind of things that I've got in my mind.
Thank you, Ben.
I'm June Fox, I'm the councillor for Exton Ward. Exton is the villages that actually surround Oakham. I've lived in Whitwell now for 18 years, and Oakham is the town where I do my shopping. I have a vested interest in making sure our town thrives and flourishes. My concerns are a lot of the people locally have stopped using the town centre due to the constant roadworks that we've actually had. I feel that we need to find a way to encourage local residents back to shop in Oakham, and also to get the tourists to spend their money when they come here to visit rather than water. The outcomes really is I would just like to see the town flourish and thrive, and I would like to see our town smartened up but also retain its current charm.
I can safely say that I was born not 300 yards from here, nearly seven decades ago. In those years, I've got to know a lot of people, both within the town, within the county, of all ages. Through a personal issue, many years ago, I stood to be on this council in 1995 when I was first elected. I've been elected every 4 years since then, as an independent councillor. While I'm talking about being an independent councillor, I think one of the most retrograde steps that this council has taken was politicising the council. Because we have had, understand we do have now, but we have had lots of topics. That's got to stop. It clearly has to stop. I mean, for example, I was walking behind two ladies in Oakham, and I just happened to hear one of them say, people speaking of councillors don't listen to you. Now, I instantly stopped and spoke to those two ladies and said, what do you mean? And the general feeling with a lot of people out there is the council will do what they want, but don't listen. That must stop. We talk about our assets. Well, we've got all the bait. We've got Rushden Water. We've got a lot of history, and we've got such an attractive county, many attractive villages. So we've got the bait there. We've just got to improve the town, not just as a shopping centre, as a place to work, a place to come for a weekend. It has so many opportunities. I feel that as a humble one, Brett Oakham, and know so many people locally, I've been representing those people for nearly 4 years, I could be considered to be a right person for this group. Happy to stop in Tesco and have a word with anyone that's got a concern. So I think that's me.
Okay. And I think you raise a very valid point that we don't want this to be a political process. The town's been here for generations, is going to be here for generations, and I think like I demonstrated at the beginning, in terms of building that consensus, everybody said by a show of hands that they kind of want to unify and try and find out to do what's best for the town. So yeah, point well made.
Hi, my name's Paul Dowse. I'm Vice Chairman of the Oakham Neighbourhood Plan Steering Group. We're a working party of the Oakham Town Council, made up mainly of residents. My main concerns in this undertaking, I think, is around the scope. Clarity on the scope. If the scope's not clear and not well defined, then we'll go on forever, I think. The other thing is the overlap with the Oakham Neighbourhood Plan itself. So we talk about green spaces. That's something that can be covered in the Neighbourhood Plan. So let me just be clear about things we actually want to get achieved or want to achieve. achieved through this process versus things which actually would be better placed in the Labour plan. In terms of contribution, as part of the Labour planning group, I guess it's really reflecting the views of the residents that have taken part in a big survey which we did last year. There were some 5,500 surveys sent out. We got back 1,592 surveys, so almost 29% response rate. And my role, I think, is to represent those views that people that bothered to vote express those views as part of this process, basically. We didn't ask directly about one way, two way, particularly, but we did ask about impact of traffic and things like that, and ask people their views on what they thought might help. So hopefully we can bring all that to the table as part of this work as well. In terms of outcomes, I think it's really coming up with some viable options which the residents of Rutland could vote on. I think some good work's been done already, but I don't think it was necessarily completely thought through. So I think there's improvements we could make to some of the options that were discussed and tabled. That's it.
Thank you again. And we won't cover what the neighbourhood plan's role is within this, except to recognise that there's a definite overlap that we need to be clear about the relationship between the neighbourhood plan, wider town and development in particular, and the function of the town centre going forward in serving new and existing residents. And evidence that you've got from that consultation is going to be key, and that's evidence about what people think about the town centre economically, socially, in all sorts of ways, of which traffic is just one issue. What we want to find out is what people want out of the town centre going forward,
that was actually captured as part of the survey. So
great.
On the website, there is loads of information about the survey and what people's views are.
Great, and we'll get to draw on that.
So I'm Nick Woodley, I'm the Oakham Town Council representative. So I'm going to talk about my contribution first, which is I am here for the council. No, I am not one voice, I am the voice of the many. I've already garnered opinion, discussed with my fellow councillors what we've had already in terms of feedback, approaches from the public, what we've learned in the last year. So I want you to consider I'm not Nick Woodley, I am Oakham Town Council, and the views are the views of the council as a whole, not my own. Where I will have individual concerns, I'll make it completely clear that they are mine and not the town council. But from a concern perspective, this is one that has been discussed by the council, is we would like to understand the constraints of this process. So we don't want to disappoint or frustrate residents or any members of this group further by not understanding what is possible. Waving a flag saying that we're going to create the Mona Lisa or an Eiffel Tower, and that's what we need, is going to be pretty fruitless for all of us. So what we want to establish early on is the constraints we're working to and how that can be delivered to our residents. From an outcome perspective, certainly we've identified the need for improved infrastructure in terms of the way the town deliver services, whether that's recreational facilities, lighting, and event support to encourage visitors and shopping in the town, support for the market. And one of the things that comes a lot and is very clear and loud to the town council is parking and the provision of facilities for disabled access. And that's me.
Thank you. Yes, my name is Alistair Mann, I'm a ward member for Oakham North West. I was born and bred in the county, I was born in Emmingham, but for many years I lived in Germany. And so I was able firsthand to see that nothing had actually changed in Rutland or in particular Oakham when I came back from Germany in 2004. My concern is predominantly that we reach, like Councillor Callaghan said, that we reach a consensus and that we start with glorious opportunity to start with a blank campus so we can build from there, and hopefully by 6 to 9 months we've come out with a terms of the, everybody would like the aesthetics of the town to improve, but the functionality has to improve with it. So we've got to resolve the traffic flow, it's a big issue for a start, and like parking and other things that go with it. That's about it as far as I'm but I'm keen that we sort of start, especially what's gone on these last 3 or 4 months there, that we start now with a fresh start and then everybody gets a better crack at the work.
Good. Well, thank you all, and thanks for taking the trouble to think about the questions that I posed. That was really helpful to me. I don't know who else did the maths, but I reckon, and perhaps I'm being kind here, there's about 350 years of experience of Rutland and Oakham placed within it, lined up here, and possibly more, possibly less. And all people in different ways that have shown their commitment to different aspects of the town centre. So thanks for stepping forward and contributing to the task of finished group. I kind of just want to address the silent people within the room a little bit, really. It feels a little bit sat here, the way that we're set up is a bit like question time without the questions, really. And if you can just kind of bear with this, because you're sitting there listening and probably want to say things, but what we're trying to do is, these people have stepped forward and they're going to engage in the process and contribute to it. And then we've opened it up so that people can come and observe, and it's great that you have tonight, so that you know what's going on, there's kind of no secret. I'm sorry if for you, like me, it feels a bit odd that you're sat there quietly, but I guess we're all used to going to the theatre and the cinema and not rustling our popcorn and all those sorts of things, really. So do come up at the end and chat informally if you've kind of got concerns. Later on, as we go on, we'll be thinking of ways and creative ways, and I think, as somebody said, it's not about representation isn't just about being in that lineup. It's how we draw on surveys that have all already gone on and speak to different groups that aren't represented here. So there will be ways of feeding into the process as well. So I kind of hope you get that. It's sort of slightly strange format. Question time without any questions. What I want to do now, and we're on schedule time-wise, but I wanted to allow half an hour for that, and we've just allowed about half an hour for that. So thank you for mostly, with the exception of me and maybe a couple of others, for sticking to the 90 seconds. But that was really insightful. What we're going to talk about now is in terms of reference and different aspects of that. And in a sense, although people in the group were beginning to jump ahead to solutions and issues, actually the terms of reference is a bit about, it's not what we do, but it's the way that we do it. So how are we going to get there? How are we going to come with a process that is inclusive, brings other people's views onto the board, gets everybody rowing in the same direction, whatever metaphor we want to use. How do we do that? How do we develop an evidence base and an understanding that draws on existing information to make sure we're coming up with solutions to the real issues and building a consensus around what those solutions are? So I want to now spend time thinking, yes, on some of those outcomes in broad terms, but really about making sure, and we're defining what's called the terms of reference, which will be no more than 2 pages long, and we want to turn around that within the next week, so we're on a tight time schedule. And I just want to check that everybody's happy with that time schedule. It is very tight, and that doesn't rely on people who are on the task and finish group in particular, to having discussions with the groups that they represent. But there shouldn't be anything too frightening within the terms of reference. We've made available in the public documentation pack 2-page reference for mental health
pages of text. So that's what we're trying to achieve, really. And that's our main outcome from tonight, is that equivalent of 2 pages. So we're focusing on not what we do, but the way that we do it. One of the things that we've talked about already, kind of taking the next item on at the end of the agenda, is to make sure we've got the right membership or channels of representation to make sure that we are reaching out into the whole, not just Oakham community, but the Rutland community that's served by Oakham. So I want to allow just kind of 15 minutes to kind of just dig in a little bit from the Task and Finish Group members for any concerns, thoughts, in terms of have we got the membership right? What do we look for in terms of those members that are there? And in terms of any other new members that we may want to bring to the table, as well as bearing in mind, which we'll have a little bit of scope to think about more today and a lot more scope to think about in the future, is how do we reach out and engage people interactively and imaginatively in terms of what are the issues facing the town. But I'll just open it up to the Task and Finish group. What I'm looking today is to agree criteria for members of the group to follow. So things I'm thinking about are, what is your way of when we discuss things that you bounce them back off other people, either as an elected member, as a business representative, neighbourhood plan, town council? Have you got a public forum in place? Have you got good lines of communication? Have you got a wide membership base? How can you help us develop a consensus and bring everybody on board? And if you need any help with that, what help do you need with that? So yes, kind of open it up for discussion.
You did mention membership, you seem to have jumped past that. Now, we as proposed members for this group...
No, I haven't jumped past that.
Okay, well, can I just make a point then, that we have all received quite a number of emails from concerned persons within the Dower County feeling that there's inappropriate or insufficient representatives from the general public. And at the last, when we went to the Task and Finish, the scoping meeting, we talked about the possibility of bringing it up to 12 on this panel. And I don't know quite, you said you haven't finished, you talked about membership, so I'm not quite sure where we are.
Let me clarify.
Yes, please.
Question might have not been clear, is what are the criteria that we're looking for members of the Task and Finish group to follow? And therefore, that will guide our current members, and that will help us recognise if there's a need for additional members, and we can have up to 2 additional members, what criteria we'd be looking for those. So I don't want to talk about particular names. What I want to establish is what are the criteria for membership existing and support they may need and new members. Does that help?
It does.
Good.
I think all of us here, we all shop in the town. Most of us work in some description within the town. So they're two very important issues for any potential new members. And let somebody else have a word.
And yes, you have your role as individuals. What I'm interested about is how you bring the community that you represent with you. In the same way you talk about a town council, you'll represent, there's channels within town council to make sure you're representing the whole town council, not just your personal views. Yeah.
Sure. So from the neighbourhood planning point of view, we've done a number of things. We have consultation sessions at Tesco's, anywhere at Abbas, Aldi. Where we go through what we're doing. We We've had sessions at Victoria Hall to go through and gather views from residents about all sorts of topics, transport, green spaces, housing, etc. We have a website where we gather all the information, it's all in the public domain. And a big survey, which is the biggest thing we probably did, the biggest undertaking from the local plan. And that gathered a lot of information about the views of residents in terms of the town centre and the wider open space, as it were. So it's just getting out there and getting engaged with people. We've got links into different groups as well, which we use. But this is exploiting that network, I guess.
If I said to you as a group, and you've got that body of evidence, haven't you? And that's fantastic, because it's not Paul's opinion, it's not even the neighbourhood plan steering group's opinion. It's 2,500, did you say? 2,500 residents' opinions. So if I said to you, we want to bounce something off the neighbourhood planning steering group, you go back and you have monthly meetings, or?
Yeah, so the views are representing on the residents, not that of the open neighbourhood planning steering group.
Yeah.
So what I would do, and the other members would do, is look at the evidence that we have and pull out that evidence that is relevant to the discussion we have. And we did that as part of the first process. We provided some written information from the big survey that related to the topics that were being discussed and debated.
And if we wanted to, between meetings, monthly meetings, we wanted your group's opinion. I can't just pick on your group to illustrate others. You by email or face-to-face meetings, say,
Well, we have monthly meetings normally, but we can organise special ones if there's a need to do it. Email.
Okay. So I hope that helps the rest of the group sort of say, that's a nice example of there's a well-established group, has a body of evidence it can draw on, and has people that come together monthly. So I'm quite confident in terms of that being one representative group, that it meets those kind of clear criteria of how a group can work.
I think one of the biggest challenges we found as well is getting representation from younger members of residents, things like that. So the survey, I think, when we looked at the age profile, it was more towards the elderly end rather than the younger middle-aged end, to be honest. So that's the challenge. And that's if you're going to bring new members onto this sort of part four or whatever, it's to get people who've got networks into that younger population.
I think it's right. It's networks, it's engagement, it's been creative. Let's face it, people under 26 have got more exciting things to do than be here tonight. But it doesn't mean there aren't ways of reaching out to them. And we need to find ways of doing that, yeah. What about other groups? In terms of, we talked about business representation, didn't we?
Yeah, so Open Town Partnership has been working quite hard the last few months, and we have recently sent out our first newsletter to all businesses that have signed up to our mailing list. We meet on a monthly basis, and obviously if I'm going to think that I need to go back and discuss urgently, if I just say about the weeks, we've got to get this sorted in the week, we can get together or we can do it by email. We have been involved in consultation processes with the councils before, and I know that's a key part of Open Town Partnership, so we are definitely a body there that is willing to help with anything to consultation and reaching out to residents and businesses. But we are definitely making strides in contacting traders recently, and we're trying to do the same across the board.
Okay, thanks for that. I don't know if you want to add anything, Tim, in the sense you're wearing at least two hats, but have a business connection.
The Oakham two-way, which we started to stop what seemed to be run to steamroller through, has really morphed now into making sure that we do something to regenerate the town, and maybe the Oakham two-way has got to rise above that. It did its job in that it stopped what a lot of people didn't want. And therefore, our group, we certainly don't want to be remembered as the group that stopped the regeneration of Oakham. And we've now become very concerned and involved, and we've done, groups have been very active in carrying out surveys with the business community, with the residents, to try and come up with a good idea of what most people want. We have to realise we're not going to please everybody, but if we could please 80% of them, I would look at that as a great success.
Okay, so the channel, there are two channels to engage with businesses. Maybe we just need to think in terms of communications, how the two of you, and others as well, communicate to businesses only once necessarily, so that there's not over consultation. But so
the great problem is getting people motivated to respond. They'll all whinge about what went wrong, but they don't really want to wave the flag and say, this is what I think, and this is why I think.
Yeah, I'm used to working, and it's quite... Last week, I was working in Taunton in Somerset, and personally, I spent just 2 days going into every business in that area, speaking to every market trader, getting a response from them, chasing up today by email, and I got written responses from 65% of the businesses. So, and that took me 2.5 days of time. And it was, so there are ways, and we can talk about ways if they need to be added to that. In terms of what we probably need to think in terms of the businesses is how often we need to engage them when we're talking about items around this meeting. The town partnership is kind of well structured, but might need some support to reaching out to the businesses. And okay, two-way speaks to a wider audience, including businesses, isn't it? And what we don't want three people asking the same businesses the same questions, really. Okay. Anybody else want to chip in terms of from a member's point of view? Of course, you're out on the ground in your wards all the time.
Serving over many years, and that is the quality and accuracy of information we're given. And I just want to put a stake in the ground now to make sure that we do have the quality and the accuracy of the information upon which we're to make decisions.
Yeah, no, that's right. I keep messing up my microphone. Communication is absolutely key. I did a piece of work five Welsh towns in Pembrokeshire last summer, and we kept going on about communication, because you get Chinese whispers otherwise if you don't communicate effectively, and they'd spent, I think it was £300 million, I don't know, a lot of money, and the communications about it were great. And then somebody said to me, oh, Chris, I really get the importance of communication, and I said, great, I was expecting interactive multimedia, social media campaigns, and they said, what we need to do, isn't it, we need to put the minutes on the website, don't we? And I thought, well, that's a start. But you're not going to get the 16-year-olds who are going to come home and go, you know what I'm going to do tonight? I'm going to look at the town council website. And you've got to be a kind of bit more creative at some stage, kind of along the way. So I think we're getting there in terms of criteria. What I just want to float without kind of naming names or
we have a youth forum because we have representation on the health and wellbeing board from that. So I would suggest actually if you're going to bring anybody additional on, looking at us all here, that would actually be more beneficial than anything else, if I'm being honest. So if we wanted a non-council elected member, actually somebody from youth forum would be a lot more worthwhile. And they do meet, and they're not a large group, because you're right, trying to get effective, but you actually would have a young board, because they will ask people who we might then engage with different questions than we would.
Okay, and then in terms of what I'm looking at, Beth, you're saying they have meetings?
Yeah.
They have meetings, they have channels of communications, and they're constituted in some way. And it's a different sector, so yeah, that's a valid point.
We haven't got on the panel anybody representing the residents of the town centre. People that live in the middle of Oakham who will be affected by the traffic and everything else. We don't seem to have any representative on here.
As an individual, rather than I live in Oddington, the opposite this building, and I walk into town every day and spend my pounds and my pence in town. So as an individual, I can help.
Okay.
I echo the sentiment. I think from a representation point of view, the only thing I'm slightly concerned about is access and representation from disability groups that we probably are a little like. I'm not sure if the council group, what sections you represent, so maybe someone here is actually aligned to that. That might be something we need to consider, because certainly disability access comes up a lot for residents as feedback.
As a former portfolio holder for adult social care, then I've got quite a few links there, but actually professionally I'm the director of Sure Trust, which is a national disability charity, so I hopefully can contribute on both of those angles.
Okay, and again we can look at whether it's representation on this group or means of engagement, but you raise a valid point about understanding specialised user needs. And about residents, obviously all the ward councillors, that's part of your job to represent residents, but I know it has been talked about and discussed about are there other channels for engaging residents, either on the group or through wider consultation. I think what I'd say is if there are representative groups out there for whether it's town centre residents or residents more widely, then I'm not averse to having I think the phrase would be both participatory democracy and representative democracy represented, if that makes sense to anyone else.
I was just thinking on sort of getting messages out further, just from Oakham South West Ward. I can think of two groups that have set up as residence groups for other issues, be it the traffic on Bronson Road or the larger plans for development of Rutland. Both of those have really good networks, and I have direct links into them. So in actual fact, if we produce a regular update, actually we can tap into the groups we already do and ask them to distribute it. So actually to get wider distribution, they don't necessarily have to be on the group. Actually, as board members, we know who the people are that can distribute information for us very quickly and get it out to the wider population, particularly with their own wards, but I would guess across the whole of Oakham.
Yeah, one more point and then we'll wrap this bit up.
Richard,
you mentioned earlier in the meeting regarding the number of younger people here tonight. How will the younger population of Oakham and Rutland be represented on this group?
We already communicated within the council about getting our communications officer to ensure that whatever's discussed is put out by the social media platforms from the council, and that I think is underway to be implemented. So I think that anything that comes out of this, it's communicated by every possible means, that will help to sort of guarantee engagement and therefore encourage people to then contribute.
Yeah, one last point.
We've got quite an active Facebook page, Twitter page, so you know, we get quite a lot of communication, obviously, from the registrars on social. So I think, yeah, social, as long as there's somebody with social media, you'll get that.
So we blurred a bit then between communications, engagement, and membership, but of course we did. Just wrapping up the membership bit, I think there's a case to be made, and we communicate that through the minutes and social media more widely, in terms of if there are groups out there, there is a place for up to two more. We don't want to make this group unwieldy, because otherwise we'll never do anything. But if there are groups out there that represent a specialised sector, or a sector that we don't feel is fully represented in different ways, and they're a group that's well organised in terms of they have regular meetings, they have communication channels, they have some form of constitution, then either through the talking initially to the task force group members, but then communicating to Natalie's office, Natasha's office, sorry, yeah, through the governance tips, sorry, Natasha, through Natasha's office, then we'll consider those possibilities against that criteria.
Sorry to be a pain, the Constitution couldn't add two more groups and not add another councillor, because constitutionally we have to have a majority. So if you have two spaces, but the two spaces to go up to 12 would be one councillor, one representative group. If you multiply the two representative groups, you will actually end up with a group of 30, because you have to have it as majority elected members.
Yeah, no, that's right. We do have that capacity if necessary. It would be easy to add one group. We've said at a push we could add two, but then we'd have to look for another councillor to join the group as well.
Personal viewpoint, as soon as you get 10, for me, starts to become unwieldy if we're not careful. We've already had potential creeping death of everybody repeating themselves. Actually, you will end up with people not being heard if you have a bigger group, would be my biggest concern.
Yeah.
If you're going to do anything, I would say just go for that. We can add one more group representative, then we don't have to do anything else. We'll just go to the one more, so that'd still be a majority of the
so we can only have...
You can go outside of that, you can go back with the recommendation. What I'm saying is go back with the clear recommendation of what you want them to approve.
So we took place 7 and 6.